All triggers connect to blocks known as paths. Paths can contain different types of content, which you can select from this menu. All this turquoise content is visible to customers, while these blue actions are all internal and are never seen by customers. These yellow options then allow you to build branching experiences, giving customers options to choose from, or sending them down different paths. Using a combination of these elements, you can create powerful automations. Let's show you how. First, we'll add some reply buttons. And then name them. Now customers have options to choose from. Hit the red arrow to add content and create new paths. This could be any piece of content, but let's just use messages to keep things simple. It's a good idea to name all your paths clearly. Otherwise, your list of paths will soon become hard to understand, especially when you're creating longer and more complex workflows. One last thing I want to cover here then is how to connect and remove things in workflows. It's easy to remove a connection by clicking here and selecting delete, or you can just highlight the connection itself and hit backspace. As for paths, just hover over these dots for the option to delete. And the same goes for content and actions too. Anywhere you see three dots, you can click for the option to delete. Just note that sometimes you can't delete something unless you add something else first. Finally, when it comes to connecting paths, you can drag to connect them directly or open this menu to choose from your existing paths. This is often more useful if you're building a large workflow and have many paths to choose from. And that's it. Those are the ways you can manage your paths in the Workflow Builder.